The more you look at it, the sillier it seems.
Oh, man. It works if you don't think about it.
Isn't that almost, like, that could almost be the banner, the catchphrase for the entire
religion? Actually, I think that's where I got it.
Religion, yeah. It works
if you don't think about it.
Yeah. Now, moving on a little bit. How did you find out about the Rapture after party that's going on in Fayetteville?
You know, without going into too much detail, I heard about it when I covered on my Ustream show. I host a Ustream show during the week.
Please do feel free to give it a good plug.
And talking about the, what was it called? The Rock Beyond Belief getting canceled. And we were talking about our experiences because I have a lot of military fans. And, you know, because I always put I try to put our servicemen first whenever I try to thank people. Like, you want to thank somebody, thank our servicemen, because we do the jobs that not only do we not want to do, we don't even agree with. Most of the people I know in Iraq don't want to be there. So, you know, those are the people that I got to give a shout out to, because I understand exactly where they're coming from. But that's where I heard about it. You know, we were talking about our experiences in the military and how, you know, religion, and there's always, you know, a Christian chaplain. You know, you never get a Muslim or a you know, Hindu chaplain anywhere. You know, how they'll come knock on your door asking you to go to church functions and stuff. We're like, no, man, I'm playing PlayStation. It's not going down. Those
playing God of War.
Yeah, exactly. We were talking about that, and, you know, the Rock Beyond Belief thing came up, and we're like, yo, man, that's, you know, it was some BS. You know, it went down, and you could tell, like, it was, you know, if you read the accounts and what was really going down. So basically, that's kind of how I heard about an event happening. But how I heard about this particular event was somebody on Facebook hit me up about it.
Really? Yeah. Love Facebook. I gotta thank Facebook.
The Book of Faces.
The power of social networking. It really does work. It is actually, it's completely changing the face of the atheist and humanist community in this country. I mean, I have an account, I probably shouldn't say this, I have two Facebook accounts, one for my family, mm-hmm. most of whom are born-again Christians, mm-hmm. and one for my humanist atheist. Mm-hmm. And on that, I have about 2,000 friends. And I've met quite a few more now I've been to the AHA conference, but really only met about 80 of them. Mm-hmm. But it's great that they all friend one another. And often you'll find you have 750 mutual friends, wow. none of which you've ever met.
Right,
you know?
Exactly.
But it's great because we can all share ideas and experiences and funny pictures and YouTube videos.
Or we can overthrow governments, you know.
Yes! It's about time that, you know, yeah, atheists of the world unite. They say with us it's like herding cats, but it seems to be that Facebook has
got... I kind of agree with that, though. I kind of agree with that, because we had a conversation on my Facebook page yesterday. There is a... I don't know if it's a controversy. I'm not going to call it a controversy. I may be giving it too much. But there is a kind of a discussion within the secular community about secular subgroups aimed at certain minority groups and how effective or necessary that actually is. Here's an example. There is a African-American secular group in Atlanta. And someone who is not African American posted on the video that they had posted, that I had reposted of theirs, that he thought that it was kind of unnecessary to have a black atheist group or a black secular group. He didn't understand the need for it. Now, I personally disagree with this, because if you are in the black community or spend any time around the black community, you know that atheism, first of all, is synonymous with, you know, Satanism. So you're not even going to get anywhere talking about atheism like that.
It is here in the white community.
That subject has to be, you know, when you even go there, you have to use a lot of tact, because, you know, you never know how the next person is going to react, because you never know what he's been through. And, you know, cats, a lot of them link on to religion so hard, you know, it's hard to pry it away from. So you got to use some tact. And especially in the black community, if I tell them, hey, this white guy named Richard Dawkins, you know, he wrote a book, here, read it. You know, it's about why God is, you know, delusional, why believing in God is a delusion. They're going to look at me like I'm stupid. There's no way you're going to go over, because of the way that we received our religion was fundamentally different than anybody else in this country. We have to acknowledge that. Black people did not receive religion the way that other races did here in America.
That's a really interesting point, because there is a real trend, or at least there's a passion amongst a lot of people in the secular community to bring groups together under one banner. Certainly the Secular Coalition of America, this is one thing they're very strong on, is bringing all the local groups together so that we can be united as a central force. But I absolutely see what you're saying, that some groups really do appeal to a different community and come from a very, very different background and have different methods, different goals.
And I think what we're trying to accomplish is the same. It's just that the methods have to be that we use have to be, you know, adjusted a little bit. Instead of the one leap from, hey, this person is, you know, a devout, you know, pick any subsect of Christianity that he is, you know, he's a devout blah 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 Christian, you know, it's going to be a lot easier for him to come to a black secular meetup group and then go with that group to one of these bigger secular events than it is for him to just go by himself.
Right.
That makes a lot of sense.
It's not necessarily like, look, we're not excluding anybody. No one is going to say you can't be in this, you know, black humanist group because you're not black. I think that's where the message gets lost. All we're saying is to other black people who are afraid to challenge these things openly, hey, there are other black people who think like you. Don't be afraid. There's a group just like you who's willing to take that step with you. That's all.
Creates an easier door.
Yeah, it's a buffer.
Through.
That's all it is. We're not saying that this black atheist group is any more special than any other group. We're just telling other black people, because of the circumstances of our religion and our religious identity is just so out of whack. We need to tackle it internally before we can just jump from, you know, this guy going into non-belief and then going into this secular community, as if he even needs to. Doesn't even need to be like that, but at least he would know that there is a community out there of free thinkers, and there are a lot of black people. Think about it this way: if the higher up Christian people are telling you that white people are devils, and I'm telling you to read this white dude's book about not believing in God, where are you gonna go? What are you gonna think? You're going to think this dude is the devil. All I hear black people post, when I see black people post on like Black Planet forums and stuff about religion, Richard Dawkins is the devil. Like, this dude is the incarnation of evil. And I mean, it's like, really? Do you think he's eating babies?
Yeah. That's...